Arsenal career has been the constant injuries. It's unfortunate, but you cannot tell me you don't rate this guy. You cannot convince me that Gabriel Jesus went fit. Now you can complain, but he's always available. See, Jorginho will still be part of the squad. I'm not saying it will be a starter, but Jorginho will play certain games, the FA Cup, the Carling Cup, even in the Premier League. There's a great chance, let's scratch great, there's a very good chance Jorginho plays against Spurs in midfield. Even though, personally, I prefer Kai to play in the midfield, I will not be surprised if Jorginho is drafted in the midfield against Spurs. We know Declan Rice is going to miss that game based on the red card. Welcome to the present. How are we doing this beautiful Monday morning? The North London Derby is approaching us. On Sunday, Arsenal travels to Spurs Stadium to face them in the North London Derby. I am looking forward to that match with so much keen interest. I am looking forward. So, guys, before we continue, do that kind of favor, strike the like button, subscribe if you're new, and do not forget to turn on your notification bell. Very important. Like the video, subscribe if you're new, and make sure you turn on the notification bell. Gabriel Jesus, according to reports, very credible reports, Jesus should be available for the North London Derby. I'm excited. I am extremely excited. So, your boy is always injured. He's not a gunman. See, if that's your sentiment, I see he's always injured. Unfortunately, part and parcel of Jesus' Arsenal career has been the constant injuries. It's unfortunate, but you cannot tell me you don't rate this guy. You cannot convince me that Gabriel Jesus went fit. Now you can complain, but he's always available. Like I said, we have other options. There's Kai Havertz there. Even though some of you still move the goalposts, but Kai Havertz is not a striker. Just because you don't rate him and it's not your cup of tea, doesn't make it true. It does not make it true. Look at the goals Kai Havertz scoring for both club and country in the last few months. Just because you don't like him, that's solely your is a you problem. But the rest of us with some brains can tell you that Kai Havertz is a striker and can sometimes do a job as a midfielder. So, Gabriel Jesus back as a viable option for the North London Derby, either at the starter or off the bench, for me, puts a smile on my face. Puts a very, very smile. Put a smile on my face. Because we have to go to Spurs and win. And win convincingly. Even though we've won there the last two visits, we still have Spurs fans who still have the audacity, the temerity to be saying we should be beating Arsenal. Are you living under a rock? You should be beating Arsenal. I'm not saying it's impossible, but what you mean you should be beating Arsenal if you've not beaten us in the last two visits? We've gone to your stadium and beaten you the last two times. How does the shoot come? Where does it come from? Based on what? Based on history or based on antecedents? So, Gabriel Jesus potentially going to be available for this match. Puts a bright smile on my face. I don't expect him to start. Some of you might be saying, will he be fit? Yes, let's not forget. He came off the bench in our first game against Wolves, right? He has missed the last two games. Doesn't mean he's going to be much rusty. I don't think so. He was part of preseason. It's not that he has been out for 2 months or 3 months. No. He just missed the last two games, right? So he should be reasonably fit. I don't expect him to match rusty. I will know Gabriel Jesus on his day. He's a game changer. We can have a conversation about Gabriel Jesus not being little enough, but you cannot tell me Gabriel Jesus is not a game changer. I'm not buying that argument. Gabriel Jesus is a game changer. We've seen it many times on the pitch. I agree, we can have a conversation about him being little in front of goal, but you can't tell me he's not a game changer. So having him available for Spurs, for me, fills me so much joy, excitement, and I'm looking forward to it. And there's some other rumors going around about Arsenal unwilling to let Jorginho leave the club, despite Galatasaray reported interest in signing 32-year-old before the Turkish transfer window closes. See, we're not a selling club. We do not need to sell our players. We have a very close-knitted group, right? It's not over bloated, it's not understaffed, for me to use that term, for lack of a better term. for me, you have the right size. See, Jorginho will still be part of the squad. I'm not saying it will be a starter, but Jorginho will play certain games, the FA Cup, the Carling Cup, even in the Premier League. There's a great chance, let's call it great, there's a very good chance Jorginho plays against Spurs in midfield. Even though personally I prefer Kai to play in the midfield, I will not be surprised if Jorginho is drafted in the midfield against Spurs. We know Declan Rice is going to miss that game based on the red card he got. So you look at the red card he got against Brighton. So it's either we place Jorginho there or move Kai to the midfield. So this rumor, even though the Turkish transfer window is not closed, we are not a selling club. We don't need to sell Jorginho. He is not angling or pushing for a move. So this rumor for me is just baseless. I understand these mainstream guys have to push out some news for traction and for engagement, but this is rubbish. I'm 100% sure Jorginho will end the season with Arsenal. Even in January, we are not going to sell him. Now, things could change there, but I don't expect Arsenal to sell him in January. So don't be too concerned about this news about Jorginho leaving us. There is no way, with the injury to Mariano, unfortunate injury to Mariano, we are going to consider selling Jorginho. It's not going to happen. He might not be the first choice, but it's part of a closely knitted squad. So I'm not bothered about the rumors. It's just bollocks. Clubs are allowed to have interest, but will interest develop into sale? I don't think so. So the North London Bay is next. I'm looking forward to it. Gabriel Jesus' news from is exciting. And the other report that Tomiyasu too is making fantastic progress in terms of his rehab back to the score. So I'm looking for a good season. I'm looking forward to a good season. I get a 7 points from 9. It's not excellent, considering that Manchester City got 9 from 9. But it's still a long season. Just 3 games out of 38 games. Just 3 games. 35 more games to go. There's no need for the anxiety. There's no need for the angst. Let's calm down. I get it. Man City have a way of doing it. It's still in the past. There's still a good chance Man City don't win this league. See, as much as they see keep on gaslighting us that, oh, Man City, once they have their noses in front, you can't catch up. I don't think so. I don't objectively think so. So guys, let me know what you think in the comment section regarding the Jesus update. Are you excited that Jesus potentially is going to be part of the squad for the North London Derby? The Jorginho news, I don't see us selling him in this transfer window or in general transfer window. I think Jorginho will stay here to the end of the season. Now, things could change, like I said, in January, but for now, even though the Turkish transfer window has not ended, I don't see us selling Jorginho. And Tomiyasu is making tremendous progress in his rehab to back to fitness. So I'm not sure it's going to be available for selection for the North London Derby, but it's good to know that Tomiyasu is getting back to full fitness. So let me know what you think about these three topics we discussed. In the comment section, what you think. Don't forget, very important to like the video, subscribe if you're new, and make sure you turn on your notification bell. Very, very important. And I will see you guys on the next one. Keep supporting us now. Bye for now.